Welcome. In this video we will present the structure of a X2C controlled block. X2C can be used either with Scilab Xcos or with MATLAB Simulink as a frontend. The X2C blocks in Simulink differ from those in Xcos only by the missing clock input and a different mask. We are using the block named Sine 3Gen of this very simple control scheme modeled in Scilab Xcos. This block generates three 120 degrees shifted sine wave signals at the block outputs, U, V, and W. The amplitude of the three signals can be set via input A. The input named F influences the frequency of the generated signals. Since a time signal is also required in the block to generate the signals, the block is also connected to the clock block of Xcos. The structure of a X2C controlled block is now shown on the right. The green arrow always shows the layer that is currently being spoken about. A double click on the X2C block opens a mask for editing the block parameters. With the help of the conversion function, the parameter values entered in the mask are converted to the values required by the processor. The lowest layer is the C code implementation of the desired functionality of the block, which is executed periodically by the processor. Now let's take a look at how such a block is inserted into the model. For this purpose, the palette browser has to be activated in the view menu. Then we browse to the library X2C General and find the X2C Sine 3Gen block there. For adding this block, simply select the block in the library and drag and drop it into the model. The block now only needs to be connected to the other blocks and parameterized. That's it. The functionality is built in. We now delete this block again and use the already integrated one for further explanations. A double click on the block opens the block mask. The first entry is the block label, the name of the block in the model and in the C code. Let's change the name to Sine 3Gen Test. By pressing the OK button, the changes are applied, but, as can be seen in the model, the block name did not change. In order to update the block labels, a double click on the orange block, transform model and push to communicator is required. We reopen the block mask and reset the name to Sine 3Gen. Under the block label, a short description of the block functionality is given. Below the description, the block implementation is easily defined via a drop-down menu. Either fixed point 16 or 32 bits, or floating point 32 or 64 bits can be selected. A mixture of various implementations within a model is possible, and the chosen implementation is not restricted by the target's hardware architecture. In this video, we choose the 16-bit fixed point implementation for this block. For editing the parameter, you may choose to use the left or the right field. The left field allows the use of variables, but numerical values can also be entered. In the right field, numerical values can be entered using the keyboard and can be changed using the arrow buttons or the scroll wheel of the mouse. With a right mouse click on the right field, the settings for this field can be defined. An individual setting for each input field can be made. The number of fractional digits, the base value, the lower and upper limit, the step mode, and the rate of change can be set. Let us set the number of fractional digits to 0 and the add per step value to 10 and press the OK button. As you can see, the input format and the editing behavior did change accordingly. The second parameter, the offset, is not changed in this example. With this parameter, an offset shift of the sinusoidal output signals can be set. The third parameter is the sample time multiplier and determines the update frequency of the block. It is an integer value that is the divisor of the base update frequency of the application. In Xcos, this parameter cannot be changed using the block mask. Instead, it is set by connecting the red event port to the clock of Xcos. The tab controller parameter shows the controller values calculated by the conversion function. In the last tab named Advanced, special settings can be made. Depending on the control model, each block is assigned a unique ID when the code is generated. This ID can also be defined by the user. To do this, simply check the checkbox static parameter ID and enter the desired ID number. This means that the ID for this block does not change, even if the model, and thus the software, is changed. For example, if the system is controlled by a script that is using the block ID, the script does not need to be adjusted, even if the control algorithm has been changed. By enabling the conversion on target checkbox, the mask parameter are transferred to the target without a preceding conversion. The parameter conversion is then done by the target processor itself. For the sake of completeness, the mask of the Sine 3 gen block using the MATLAB Simulink frontend is shown as well. Just like in Scilab Xcos, there is a short description of the block at the top of the mask. But there are some small differences in the way numerical parameters are entered. There is only one parameter field in which you may enter numerical values and variables. Additionally, you are free to enter formulas as well as comments. In contrast to Xcos, the parameter sample time multiplier can be set using the block mask. The implementation can also be set via a drop-down menu. At the bottom of the mask, advanced settings, like setting a static block ID or enabling conversion on target, can be made. The following explanations apply regardless of the frontend used. Now we will have a look at the conversion function that converts the mask parameters to processor values. The conversion function can be implemented in Java, JavaScript, and Python. At this point, it should be noted that the X2C block generator tool supports the user in creating or modifying X2C blocks. This tool automatically generates the framework and all the basic functions needed for the conversion function in the C code implementation. Thus, the user only has to enter the conversion of the parameters, respectively the implementation of the block functionality, in the areas marked with the word user code. Changes outside the user code tags are automatically overwritten at the time the block is regenerated by the block generator. Now let's have a look at the conversion function of the Sine 3 gen block for the 16-bit fixed point implementation. The Java conversion class has two methods. The first method converts the mask parameters to controller parameters, and the second method converts the controller parameters back to the mask values. The first part of the conversion method reads the parameters from the mask. This part is generated automatically by the X2C block generator. This is followed by the conversion of the parameters. This part is written by the designer of the block. At the end, the converted parameters are set and transferred. This part is automatically generated again. The code for the second method is given below. This method implements the conversion from controller parameters to mask parameters. Let us now have a look at the functionality of the block and its implementation. This is the 16-bit fixed point implementation of block Sine 3 gen. At the beginning of the implementation, there is a short description of the block functionality. To improve the readability of the code, some definitions are made using preprocessor macros. For example, the macro amplitude represents the value of the block input A. Each block implementation provides five functions. The update function is executed cyclic. Here, the functionality of the block is implemented. This code must be written by the designer of the block. The code of the following functions is generated automatically. The init function is executed for initialization when the processor is started. Internal block variables, like the angle phi, have to be added and initialized manually by the block designer. The load function creates the data package for loading the implementation parameters from the target to the PC. In normal use cases, this function will not be used. The save function puts the parameters received from the PC into the block structure. This function will be executed when the user changes a block parameter in the model. And last but not least, the getAddress function, used by the X2C scope to determine the memory addresses of the block ports. Now we will have a short look at the header file of the block. Here the data structure is defined in which the block data is stored. Furthermore, the function prototypes are defined to be able to use these functions in other files. With X2C, the code for the model, shown on the left, can be generated automatically at the push of a button. Two files, the X2CC and X2CH file, are generated automatically. These files are introduced briefly. In the X2C init function, the parameters of the implementation are set to the converted mask parameters of the block. Then the connections of the single blocks to each other are defined according to the graphical representation of the model. For example, input A of our Sine 3 gen block is connected to the output of the constant block with the label amplitude. At the end of the X2C initialization function, the block structure is transferred to the initialization function of the block. The block internal variables and states are initialized here. The function X2CUpdate calls the update function of every block within the model. In the X2C header file, the header files of all used X2C blocks are included. A data structure for the model. Necessary tables. And the function prototypes of the X2C functions are defined. Now, this simple application is demonstrated. The X2C communicator has already been started, and a connection to the LaunchPad from Texas Instruments was established. Also, the X2C scope was started and has been pre-configured already. The three ports, U, V, and W, of block Sine 3 Gen are scoped. Additionally, the LED outport that commands the blue LED is plotted. In the model, the block manual switch is opened. Then the sampling process is started by clicking the sample button. Changing the toggle parameter of the manual switch to 1 doubles the frequencies of the sine waves of ports U, V, and W. Of course, also the blinking frequency of the LED has doubled. Resetting the toggle parameter of the manual switch to 0 restores the initial frequency. If you have any more questions or want to have some more information concerning X2C, please have a look at our website x2c.lcm.at and do not hesitate to contact us. Thanks for watching.